Rochor doctor says there is another major health care problem that is getting worse by the day. We're talking about the delaying of elective surgeries due to the coronavirus, and he fears it could lead to the loss of life down the road. Medical reporter Meg Ferris explains.
I have a patient that was supposed to get a mastectomy for breast cancer this month, and it's been put off 2 months. I don't know about you, but if I had cancer, I would not want that put off 2 months.
North Shore neurologist, psychiatrist, and pain management physician Dr. Chad Domang is concerned that the coronavirus pandemic is threatening the lives and health of people who don't have the virus.
And we do about 700 elective cases a month, but spine, heart disease, kidney disease, lung disease, you name it. You also have surgery centers and cardiologists that do outpatient procedures as well. So when you take all these numbers together, you're talking about 200,000 surgeries and procedures that have been put on hold.
I think this is the most stressed that I've ever been.
His patient, Amy Cuneo, is one of those cases on hold. She's cleared to have neck and back surgery after a car wreck, but the clock is ticking fast. A pending divorce means she will soon be dropped from her husband's insurance.
Being afraid to leave your house, but then add to, I don't know when I'm going to be able to get the surgeries, to get the pain relief that I need, the financial stress of it.
The Louisiana Department of Health and Hospitals states in part that health care providers postpone, quote, any and all medical and surgical procedures that in the medical opinion and judgment of the physician can be safely postponed. That's until April 21st, 2020. It recognizes that each case, procedure, and patient is unique and puts the decision in the doctor's hands. They say it's to preserve medical resources and keep patients from being exposed to the coronavirus. But Dr. Domang says doctors are in fear of a decision that will cost them their medical licenses.
Half the hospital staff, doctors, and nurses have been sent home because they can't do elective surgeries. And so what I fear is this bomb is growing and growing and growing. And when the government puts a pause on all medical care for the time that they're doing it, I'm really concerned that the virus is the least of our fears.
Meg Ferris, Eyewitness News.
The doctor says also without medical procedures and physical therapy for pain management, some patients say they are taking higher doses of their pain medication than the prescriptions call for.